Okay, so this video is going to be about ghost stories.
I don't know. So my sim wants to flirt with my maid.
Oh, that's really dry. So it's been thunderstorming a lot.
Yeah, that was supposed to be thunder, but it didn't work out. Someone close to you has recently died. You can bring their ashes to the science lab to restore their ghost. Don't care!
Subtitles on the screen. It's about to die.
Alyssa can tell you a story. A story about...
everything. When I was about 12, around that age, I decided to stay the night at Grandma's house, and it was the summer, and we get lots of thunderstorms in the summer. I was staying in this room, and it was storming outside. I had gotten to sleep somehow, because I was just kind of, but I was in here asleep, and when I turned over, I kind of woke up for a minute, because the storm was so loud, and I had this whisper in my ear. It was like somebody just went to my ear and went, you know, that sound in my ear. And at first I just rolled over and ignored it because I said, oh, I'm just hearing the trees hit the window. Because when they hit the window, it makes a scraping sound. So I kind of ignored it. I rolled over, and I had a doll with me that I liked to snuggle with, and I just squeezed him and rolled over. Again, I woke up because the lightning, thunder just like shook the windows and everything. It was just so loud. And I rolled again, trying to get back to sleep, and then this raspy male voice was in my ear, and it said, it was kind of like, get out, you know. Without thinking, I said, no, go away, and rolled over and hugged my doll. Then I thought about it for a minute, and I opened my eyes. I was so scared to turn over. I felt like someone was standing by the bed. It was so scary. I rolled out of bed and just booked it out of this room and across the living room, scared to death. I didn't want to turn around. I didn't look in the room. I just bolted out the door, which was open, thank the Lord, or I wouldn't have been able to escape.
Funny mental image. Busting into the door.
Through a stick to her. Ah! It was pitch black because we didn't leave any lights on. And the kitchen door is always open. And the kitchen was pitch black. And I did not want to look through the kitchen door because I was afraid something was there too. I ran into my great-grandmother's room and stayed in the chair the rest of the night. His sister, and we were little, and we were staying on the couch bed, and we were supposed to be going to sleep, but you know, kids sometimes don't listen to their parents.
Of course they don't.
And we were going to play with the dolls, and we weren't going to go to sleep because we weren't tired yet. And he stops and looks at the doll. And she just stares at it, and I'm like, what? What, did it break? Because I thought maybe I accidentally broke something off of it, because the pacifier was about to break off anyway. But she looked at the doll, and then she looked at me and said, the doll just moved. I thought she was just trying to scare me, because pranks were kind of a big thing. Mm-hmm. And we looked at the doll, and I could have sworn it had moved, because the way I had laid it on the bed, it was not like that anymore. It was face up, and its head was, like, looking straight at us. We both got out of the bed and ran to the back of the house to my grandparents' room. We stayed there all night long on the floor, and I don't think we even slept. I think we just kind of stayed there until we dozed off at some point. I never touched that doll again. I never would hold it again after that night. Oh, it popped. That was A Million Faces by Me. Well, that's our spookiness for right now.
My fart.
Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll keep you up to date in my life and such. Bye! And keep those doors...